this room off as a spare room. I mean, it's not Nan's actual room, really. It's a spare room. I've just had to clearing all the books to take to the Oxfam bookshop. And I have to say, for me, books and the reading of books to the girls, that's been such a major part of me, my being a dad. And all the books that you'd escape, I mean, for me, books and the fiction and escape and fantasy lands and, you know, sharing those stories with the girls, and there'd be certain ones that they love listening to again and again. And then I'd shout and perform the stupid parts of the book that were, you know, and I'd scare them and do silly things with them. And just literally going through all these books, taking them off the shelves, it's like seeing their childhoods flashing before me, all the bedtimes. It's like all their bedtimes flashing before me. I just went downstairs and said, oh, I feel a bit sad actually doing this, because I'm doing it in case there are some keepsakes. I like to keep a few things in the loft because I know that when they're all older, if they're anything like me, they'll love to kind of pore over old stuff. Obviously the old maths folders are going in the skip, but all the other stuff, you know, the occasional book or a little project that Kiki did about Chi-Chi. It's making me really sad. Anyway, I went downstairs to mention that, and of course the girls being teenagers, they're just like, oh, come on, Dad, get over it. And Maddie's like, oh yeah, you'll get over it soon. But for me, books, maybe it comes from my mum, because she's a librarian. But for me, as I just said, the books, the pages, the stories, the worlds that we'd enter together, they'd be my companions, and we'd go on journeys. And I literally can't go on those journeys with them anymore. I mean, imagine sitting down a 27-year-old and saying, let's read this book together. You can't go over it. You can't go. I'm finding books here that I used to read to Izzy. I hate this part of being a parent and the kids growing up. I mean, I think I'm going to struggle with empty nests so much more than that. Really am. Because being a dad for me was so important. Not having a dad. Being a dad is so all-encompassing. It's why not having spent most of their childhoods with them, with Flo and Izzy, is such a still a heartbreak for me. But bedtime's packed away, never to be seen ever again. Apart from the few I've put in a bag for life and I'm putting in the loft. Finally.
Da da da, a paddy box.
James,
this is so. Your mammy always told you sharing is caring.
Oh my god.
The paddy box. Cheers, you're fucking speckin' sound.
Aww.
Looking forward to seeing you and Orla in the new future. Lion's tea.
Look in the box.
What's in the box? Da da da, gobshite!
I love that.
Oh, yeah, James, that is so kind. Aww. Thank you. We're getting straight into potatoes.
Potatoes.
Straight in. The best crisps in the world, guys.
So, guys, I've just been in there trying to generate as much gas as possible because we're in a bit of a crisis. So, but look.
We're finally doing these cupboards because the girls said they were scared that was going to fall on them.
What?
That cupboard, because of all the...
Oh.
All the... Everything was squeezed into
a lot.
This is the right thing to do because usually people put pans.
No.
But I thought that was quite good for plates.
Oh, you're being innovative.
Don't you think?
Sure.
So now I've got to be brave and throw out some of these pans.
Yeah, I mean, I think as long as you don't put anything too tall in there that can fall over.
Yeah.
I think they're all right.
These over here, no, because they could fall. They're wobbly. Because it's a bit wobbly.
And
now I've already got
too much. So, Nat, you've got your favourite bottoms on.
Only because I'm filthy and I'm rolling around on the floor. I've got a scrub floor, so we've got a camera crew coming to it. Yes. Most of the people that work at ITV are going to be here tomorrow.
I have never known so many people for 2 minutes to film.
Unbelievable, there's 9 people coming. Look at that up there. Is that going to show?
Well, that is what the builder that's coming on Thursday is.
But that won't show, will it?
No.
Anyway, it's at our house.
Oh, look.
I tried to fix him. Got knocked with the pan.
You hit him.
It's been hidden forever. Everyone knows about it. Oh my God, you've just dropped the horn that I've kept so well. I tried it. No, you can see I did super glue.
I've been waiting to say this for a long time. Hang on. Give me the horn. God.
The super glue didn't work, so we've got to get some other... Look, you won't see it at all once it's on. I tried it with super glue. It doesn't work. But anyway, he needs to go to the hospital. He needs to go to the unicorn hospital.
It's just like a horse now, doesn't it?
Oh, I feel so
ill. So, Nadia, explain the thing that Maddie was telling us about Florida Man and the birthday for our subs to do.
So, basically, Google your birth date and Florida Man, and some dreadful crime will come up that a Florida Man has done. Mark's was Florida Man arrested for having sex with a miniature pony multiple times.
It's weird, isn't it?
Mine was... Careful. What was mine? Oh, I can't remember now. But honestly, no matter what your birthday is, something will come up.
Yeah.
Actually, we should get people to do it on Coffee Moaning. Yeah, they say their date and then you read out.
Yeah, I'll read them
out. Yeah, that'd be really good.
Anyway, what's the... Oh, look, I like this.
Yeah, your mum bought me that.
Oh, she's bought you some nice things for the kitchen.
Mum's great, yeah.
Remember, she got you that lovely... having a coffee. You alright, babe?
I'm just trying to work out what to do next.
That's the sound of Nadia thinking.
And it's not good. Bowls here. Bowls and smaller plates there.
How's your ADHD coping with it, Ned? Yeah. You're going against your nature.
I don't like it.
I don't like it. Okay.
I mean, all other people I know say things like, I love to have a good sort out. I hate to have a good sort out. I feel just drains now. I don't know what to do with all the last bits. That's always my problem. I mean, do I just throw away what the last bits?
I think, yeah, where you've got odd bits and bobs, you do. Because you've got to skip, get it in it.
That's what I was doing with Ned today, because
yeah.
I thought...
But you get attached to it. I mean, like, Adderley crockery can all go in the roof.
I like having the Adderley crockery for
sometimes. It's still going on, isn't it? Mm. Okay.
I'm very tired, though.
No.
I don't like it. I don't know where to put this shit.
Yeah, this is odd stuff. Well, it's the fucking French cupboard around the corner. Let me just show you the scale of the problem around here. Though you will see, come with me and you'll see a world of deep imagination. Come with me and you'll see. Da, 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 da. Why don't you smash the plates on the floor? So there you go. Look, and Santa is functioning as a vital cushion to some of the crockery in here. So I better place him back. He's a vital cushion. So are these picture frames, really important to balance bowls on. Look, here's a Christmas tree for a cake. That's really key. Yeah, that's all really important. And we've got to say an especial thank you to Hazel. These are absolutely lovely, and we've got them out for Christmas, haven't we, Ned? Beautiful.
Oh, God, so lovely.
Beautiful,
beautiful. Dina came in and tried to nab them.
Yeah, Dina and Nick tried to nick them. They're going to go on our tree, special place this year. But I might have to put them in the loft first. Hey, you all right there, babe?
It's still fun at times. Many times it's still fun, but it's always still...
You are not going for that draw.
Maybe I want to kill myself.
Oh my God.
Look in there. Look in that, those two cupboards.
Babe, this is amazing. Oh my word.
No, it's so exciting, isn't it?
It is. I'm having
what
to go.
What about the scale up and do the crossing? I'm being quite brutal, just throwing shit away.
Yeah, almost without thinking about it.
Yeah, because
I'm acting on that.
Do you
need
that?
Yeah. I saw a moth in your room. I thought they weren't. I thought they didn't go for clothes.
No, a flying around moth isn't a moth that eats your stuff.
Yeah, but it was a tiny one.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Probably your stuff that you bought from next door, to be honest.
I keep blaming it on me.
No, but nobody can blame it, but that's what I'm saying. Probably has company. You haven't done it on purpose.
Please acknowledge that.
Let's face it, that's
you haven't done it on purpose. Yeah, I went and got a moth, put it in a glass bottle.
No, that's where it's come from. That's where they were living. Big time.
Oh, this is amazing. Tell me when you want me to take that in the...
In
the...
Okay, yeah.
Huh? I know, but this is great. This needs to be done. Can't wait for you to do this one.
Steam all the floors.
Well, I would just do that drawer and then move on to the bigger stuff.
No, the only reason I'm doing this is because the skip is going.
No, I know.
Can you get me another bag?
I don't think I've ever seen the back of that cupboard.
No, this is where I keep that oil that I... Because you should never put your oil down the sink.
So it should be packed away and put in the rubbish, right?
Yeah.
Ian's moved out, which means I can visit please.
How's that
gone?
Hey! Badge, Nads. These are the ones that boys go mad for in playgrounds.
Oh, how exciting.
Yeah, it was exciting. It is exciting. Why aren't you excited?
I can't get this off.
What is it?
Oil.
Don't use all the washing liquid, you ain't got any.
We can buy more, babe. We'll
sold out. They need carbon dioxide. What do you mean? We've got supermarkets with absolutely nothing on the shelves.
Are you going down to supermarkets?
I don't know. This is very uninteresting.
I think you'll be shocked.
Huh?
I think you'll be shocked.
Do you?
Mm.
Or what?
How little there is in the supermarket.
Well, have you been in one?
Yeah. And I've just tried to do a shop on Ocado. There's so many things not available. And Dina said Sainsbury's in Crystal Palace today was frustrating. Like, no berries, no blueberries, no raspberries, no nothing. No organic chicken. No chicken breasts, no normal chicken breasts.
The ready-made meals is the danger as well.
She just no lemon sip.
Oh my God. So is this a priority, what you're doing for tomorrow?
Well, no, it's because the priority is because the skip's going. So this is skip stuff. Oh my God, 2016. Oh my God, I've had this stuff forever.
Chi-Chi will have it.
Chi-Chi would have it. Chi-Chi will have anything. I think Chi-Chi would even eat sip, to be honest.
Oh, nice.
She would.
But would she eat...
Mark! Unnecessary! Can you put these in there?
You probably would. Put them in a bag.
Mark,
it's good to see we've still got Trivial Pursuit questions.
No.
It's vital, this bit. In which country do the Galapagos Islands belong?
Oh my God, I know that. Where is it?
Ecuador.
No, I didn't know that.
Which English city was known by the Romans as Aquae Sulis?
I don't know.
Bath.
I don't know these answers.
Oh, okay. Mike.
I just put it all in the bin.
Yeah, we've never... I mean, let's face it, have you gone to the drawer to use any of that?
No.
None of it?
None of it.
Yeah, there's a compelling argument to just save the poo bags and just chuck it all in.
Unless you've got... what I found that you're always looking for.
Oh, yeah. I've got others, though. Oh, shit.
Oh, look, cholesterol home kit. We never did that,
did
we?
That's good. Cholesterol home kit. Trivial Pursuits question. What's that? That's really ghostly. Why is it it's doing it itself? What else have you done over here? Okay, wrong draw. Keep thinking it's making me a coffee. Look at that. No. How do you think she's done, Chi-Chi?
No. Oh, look at this. I used to love this radio.
Oh, look at this. Hang on.
This is what I used to train to the marathon to.
Hold on. Oh, look. Oh, wow.
And a little radio.
Oh, yeah. Roberts.
I used to love that.
I used to, and whenever you ran past the transmitter, it would go off. No. Do you remember that?
No.
No. Oh, I do. Babe, I just think you need to get rid of it all. What is a Toro story?
Brand new leather. What's this?
No, get rid of it. Oh, right, look, that's a case for your phone.
Yeah, it doesn't fit my phone.
It might do, but it's the same.
No, it's too small.
Oh, what a shame.
Sorry, I'm just so tired now. I'm just on autopilot.
Okay, careful. Throw it.
We're going to be going to Virgin Gym soon, and we're going to need one.
Oh, I've been looking for that everywhere. Seven of Diamonds. Look, seriously though, we need those staples.
Oh my God, Tubbs, I'm a broken woman. I'm an absolute broken woman. Two solid days, and most of the evening, I have been cleaning the house, ready for the crew from ITV. Do you want to see it? Oh, if only I'd done a walk round first. Mark would be killing me. But it kind of like grew on me. I started cleaning one thing and then I cleaned another thing. It's that hyper-focus that ADD people can have. So it's either hyper-focus or total fucking madness. But anyway, I'm gonna show you everything. Every little corner is clean. I even dusted down there. I brushed all the stairs. Look, there's nothing on the stairs. Whose house is this? Even through there, look, all clear. It's quite a nice house really when you can see it, isn't it? Look there, guys. Da da da, da da da, da 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 da. Polished ovens, don't look inside them. Of course I've got all my perfect drawers. Everything is perfection. Got all the mugs out ready for the crew. They're gonna think I'm the most organized person in the world. Only you know what it's really like. Doesn't it look nice though, guys? Oh my God, if only I could keep it like this. Oh, look. Look. The dust around here is about an inch thick, I'm not gonna lie, it really was. Bloody brilliant, eh? I'm so exhausted though now. Do you want to see the bit behind the door? Okay, come with me. Remember, I didn't shove everything from this side of the house into here. This was just already like this. So this is my ADD self. And so is that, depending on what headspace I'm in. Oh my God, Jesus Christ. So who gave you
this? Lisa is obsessed with this.
Oh my God, that's the first thing I saw when
that's
I walked in.
That's from lovely Emma B. She sent it to us.
You're joking. Not the Emma B.
The Emma B.
I love her.
Isn't it fantastic?
Oh my God, that's amazing.
I'll have to get you one.
Absolutely love it. Emma, where's mine?
But listen, I want to show you this. Come.
Let me just clean.
You're not going to believe this. Are you ready?
Shitty there. You are kidding.
I've got more.
Hang on a minute. Where's all the food and the oil that sits on?
Lise. I think next time I'll come to yours, we should do a little film of your drawers, Lisa.
Yeah, actually.
And wait for this. The pièce de résistance.
Oh my God, you are kidding me. We should have ITV round here all the time. In the cupboards get done.
There they are. This is the motley crew that's caused this.
I don't have to bloody do it.
Look.
How long did that take?
48 hours. Almost solidly through the night.
All by yourself?
Yeah.
You haven't slept?
Totally by myself.
Hey, this drawer!
No, I haven't done that one yet.
Well, this was clean.
Or this one.
Yeah, we'll put that one away.
I'll tell you what, I've thrown most of... No, I'm not. Oh, it's this one. This one. Open this one. Do you remember how you couldn't get the drawers open? They were
You couldn't even close
no.
it.
It's because I've got a skip.
Oh my God, swishy jaws.
Oh no, we can open them. Look over here. Look.
Have you done the knife drawers? She's even done the knife drawers.
Swivel the telly is the most genius idea.
I didn't even know you could swivel tellies. I suppose you can swivel whatever you want. Oh my God, this has changed my life.
Come on.
Oh, hang on. So I've never, you haven't been upstairs yet, ever, because, oh, put it back. Emma, we need another one. You haven't been upstairs yet.
No.
Because I never let you up because it's always such a tip.
I do go up and I know what it's like.
No, but you haven't seen my room with all the stuff in it.
Well, what stuff in it?
My wardrobe room. Wait there. Mark would be proud of my filming skills here. Hang on. Come in.
What am I going to say?
Oh my God.
You didn't see it with all the stuff in, have you?
No. Admittedly, I could colour coordinate it.
Yeah, but then how...
But how brilliant.
But I don't know what to do. I don't know how to sort it out. Cool. Like, I need something to go up there, up the top.
Oh, you need all storage stuff up there. Oh, my God, you can get so much in.
It's unbelievable that we still haven't got enough room.
And all those hangers need to be. Yeah, but you can get those amazing hangers. You know, the one that you go on and then it slides down and it could put, like, 12 t-shirts on one and it can make that space.
Oh right, that's what we need
it's
to do.
Gorgeous. Well, it will be after I've
yeah well I thought we could put some nice that nice wallpaper from
yes bit of muck and brass there
would look so nice.
Oh, it looks so
and there's
good.
Your gorgeous chair that I sit on to do my makeup,
and then we can color coordinate from muck and brass to the cupboards that are going to be in there, like the big storage things. Oh, I love it.
I love that there's still that left there from Maddie's room.
Yeah, I like that actually. You should leave that.
I'm gonna leave that, definitely. So here we are in my shithole. Look at it.
Look at that fucking dressing room.
It's a bit of a revelation downstairs. ITV have completely changed our downstairs room and I like it. It makes it cozy, Elise.
I know. It's really, really good.
What it needs is a back put onto it.
What, the telly?
Yeah, no, onto the bookshelves. So they could put a white back on it.
Yeah, I guess.
But where would I plug everything in?
But I quite like the see-throughness. That's what makes it more open.
But where would I plug everything in? Oh, there is actually... No, I can plug it in. There's a place to plug.
You can get a secret. You can get pop-up plugs from the floor.
Now we've got to convince Mark. I think the girls will love it because they don't like the room being that big. This isn't ever, ever cosy. Yeah. So I'm now going to reveal to you my co-star for today. He's a world-renowned actor. You guys might know him, actually. Yeah. Yeah? Have you guessed? Da-da-da-da! Nadim Sawalha is my co-star today. So, yeah, Lisa's going to slap a bit of makeup on him. And then we're going to do the can-can together. You wait till you see the house, Dad. It's a complete, like, movie set. Lights, everything.
Really?
You're proper.
Lovely.
All right, I'll come back and get you in a minute. All right. Well, about half an hour.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
So Teddy is on the set. Lisa is making him up.
Yeah.
Make him more beautiful, Lisa. I don't think it's possible.
I don't think it's possible.
Go on. Try.
So, Lisa, Teddy has suddenly gone into a diva demands, hasn't he?
Yeah.
He's refused to say another line until he's had a cheese and chutney sandwich. You'll be asking for a milk bath next. Oh, don't worry, she's fine. She's a drama queen.
The idea that location means there's food.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You'll get food on your feet.
Yeah.
Are you begging? Are you begging, Chi Chi? Are you ready for your close-up? So weird having all the lights out in the garden, isn't it?
Punk lives. So just never mind the Buzzcocks, back on Sky Max tonight, 9 p.m. Don't be a muppet and miss it. God save the Queen.
So up and down. Oh, Mark.
Ow.
Have you done both sides? Right.
Oh, God.
Now, right up your nose. Further. That's nowhere near enough. More.
Okay.
More, Mark.
No, it can't go any further.
You've got to go beyond where it's going.
That's true. No. That's true.
That's not far off enough. That's hardly anywhere.
Somewhere. I feel like I've got a fucking hole in my nose. You said put it more. It was going to come out my fucking eyeball. You just fucking said that. Put it in quick. I'm not doing that again.
No, you're going to shove it in.
Mark,
into my eye.
Don't jump.
You don't know how long my. Stop it!
Is it tickling?
Yes! Take it out! Fucking hell! Fuck off! Never put anything up your nose that long. That was fucking awful. You fucking joker.
Isn't that how long it's been?
No!
No
way you've never got a positive test.
10 times!
You put it up 3 seconds.
Mark, 10 times.
That was an eternity. It's hard on my fucking eyeball.
Look,
this
eye. Have
you
seen
all the
Indian women, they run crying
in films in India, run away. That held down.
You don't know how long my nose is.
Look.
Oh.
Look. Oh
my God.
I've had such a massive.
Where have all the mugs gone?
Clear out of this, look. Chopped, wow. I've got some in the dishwasher. I chucked loads away, we're out of date. You know, I'm always nagging you guys about your out of date spices.
Oh, they meant mugs.
No. Looking good.
Looking very good.
So,
all I've got left. Oh, I've got this one as well.
Wow.
It took ages. All the pots were so sticky. The sides were sticky. I've just cleaned it all. So now I've got this one.
Oh, that's horrendous.
That's horrendous. What's this one, Mark? What's this one? I don't know how to do it.
It's because the actual shelves are useless.
Yeah.
That's why.
Yeah. I don't think I can do it today, I'm tired. Close it. So it's Friday night and we are going to pick up Kiki from Camden. We haven't got much petrol. And there's queues at the petrol station. There's traffic jams. But hey, the government will tell you, it's no problem here.
The queues
there's nothing to worry about.
The queues at our local petrol station were running around the block. And I didn't think to get any today.
Oh, God. It's like the beginning of pandemic when you couldn't get flour.
Yeah, do you remember how to get it? It's sort of on the quiet.
So we've not got enough petrol. We've got no HGV drivers. We've got inflation. We've got food shortages. And they're cutting 20 quid a week to universal credit.
And the roads are closed.
But the Tory is at the highest in the opinion polls they've been in decades.
And Biden's at his lowest.
It's so weird, isn't it?
It's all so strange.
So, as you may or may not know, in vlog terms, we are in the middle of a fuel supply crisis. Try driving around. You may have seen Nadia reporting about us driving around last night, picking up Kiki. Every petrol station rammed with queues. It's the same again today, if not with knobs on, and even worse. And then I remembered, I thought, hang on a minute, what about when I made that really obvious stupid mistake and ran out of petrol, pulled the car up, got some petrol? Wasn't a lot left though. Then I had a second thought, I thought, what about the jerry can of petrol I got for the chainsaw we used several months ago? Double check that it's unleaded. Went to the jerry can, almost full. All I need to do is unattach my long thing, reattach my long thing, insert it, and pour. It's like Jeremy Clarkson there. Nads, look what I found.
Wow!
Look, went into the front garden, thought about when I had a chainsaw, found this jerry can, spout, boom, probably a can.
Where's that going to get you?
Well, it's probably going to get us out and back tonight.
You're getting stranded because of the queues.
I know. That's why I let every.
You haven't got enough petrol to sit in a traffic jam.
Well, I may as well put it in and find out, hey, naysayer.
No, I think we should get a cab.
Why not put it in? And see what the dial says. I mean, what's the point of not doing that? God, weird. Women are so weird. I'm a problem solver. She's a... We'll see. Yeah.
A litre is two of those.
Yeah, and you've probably got about 5 litres in there.
But how far does 5 litres
Well, not far, but it's better that it'll get us somewhere. I'm putting it in, I don't care. I'm putting it in. I want to see where it makes my dial go to. I love dials. Do you love dials? I love dials. Do you love spouts? I love spouts. I love sticking my spouts in things like the back of cars. Every capacity is wrong. The top doesn't fit my spout. I can't screw it on, I can't get it in. Struggling to get it in. I'm gonna have to put the phone down. So the dial was on 40. I've popped my pipe in, I've poured my petrol, I've refueled my beast. And it's gonna, yeah, as I say, it was at 40 and it's now this. The
the downside of all of it is I just stink of petrol. And yet, does anyone else like the smell of petrol? I really like the smell of petrol. I don't like the smell of diesel so much, but I like the smell of petrol. I like the smell of oil. I love the smell of chain oil. I really like Kestrel versus, was it Castrol versus, what is this? I don't know. Diesel, no, 85, no, unleaded. Diesel, no, Esso, unleaded. Unleaded circa 85, 87, I don't know, one of those two. Anyway, I've popped my load in the back of the car, I've filled her up, and isn't it weird how every sort of bit of language around cars sounds wrong? Which is why Jeremy Clarkson was well positioned to take advantage of this linguistic automobile scenario. He could mash up, crash, roll, body roll, even swerve, turn, and take skidding kind of corners with language. Because he's Jeremy Clarkson and he does that. And I'm a big Jeremy Clarkson fan. And even if he hated me, and I think he would hate me, I think he'd really fucking hate me. I think he'd think I was an absolute namby-pamby, lefty fuckwit, stupid twat-pot-pot, which he'd be right. But I like him. I don't care. It's like being the puppy of a mean owner. I want to be Jeremy Clarkson's puppy. I want him to kick me, I want him to hurt me, and I want him to leave me in corners of his fields, just neglecting me. I don't mind. That's the kind of thing I've got about Jeremy. He's my owner. I want him to be my owner. And if he loathed me, just the fact that he even mentioned my name would just be enough. It would just be enough. It would sustain me. It would maintain me. It would entertain me. Because it's Jeremy Clarkson. Just saying. Just thought I'd share that. Just want to show. We've gone from 40. Ooh. 70. That's not bad. We're out of the danger zone. We're not in a low fuel. In masculine terms, what I've done there with innovation, troubleshooting, problem solving, thinking on my feet, innovating, is that I have rescued the day, really. I've done that masculine thing of riding in, though really more like chugged into the drive, and just clinching our day, our weekend, our lives as a family, I'd say. I don't think it's an exaggeration to say that. From the jaws of immobility and a refusal to get on buses, to go on trains, laughing in the face of the indulgence of a cab. No, I've gone and I've solved. I've problem solved. I've gone out. I've indulged in my Neanderthal DNA. I've wrestled. I've hustled. I've muscled. And I've got back to the garden. I found a dirty old can in the corner, went on YouTube to double check it was the right one, plonked a long squirty thing on the end of it, shoved it in the back of the car. And if I say so myself, I've rescued the weekend. And as if proof, I'm now just gonna show you one final shot of the clock. Boom, boom. So every time I go out, it's not John Campbell anymore, is it? It's LBC. So the petrol tank has gone from 40 to 80.
Oh, well done.
I'll tell you what, popping it in and filling her up was a bit like...
Mark.
I got you what we needed for the Sunday show, but...
And for Maddie's dinner.
And for Maddie's dinner, but there's virtually nothing on the shelves. When will Brexiteers say that perhaps... That's all we want you to say, perhaps this is part of Brexit, rather than blaming COVID pandemic, as we've always said, great cloud cover. Blaming what else? Inflation.
When are we going to start blaming the fucking useless government we've got? I mean, just this situation now, right? Somebody just rang in. He's so right. He said, we've got to stop asking whether there is actually a fuel shortage. He said, it doesn't matter if there's some fuel somewhere. There is a fuel shortage.
Yeah.
Petrol stations are
closed. Oh, yeah. There's a fuel shortage for us. There might not be a fuel shortage for the country.
So you might keep saying we haven't got a fuel shortage.
Yeah, but to us around here we have.
We've got a fuel shortage.
And the other thing that I'd like to say, stop blaming panic buyers.
It's
stop
not
holding
panic.
Them responsible it for is. The problem.
I've just been listening.
It's like it's the biggest form of gaslighting, though, babe, yeah. Isn't it? We won't give you anything, and when you need it, we're going to blame you.
But also, it's the whipping up of humanity to turn on humanity and say these disgusting panic buyers. Mm. And they just had a really good social psychologist on saying, he said, listen, people aren't panicking. There is a fuel shortage, even though someone... And they have work to go to, children... Loads of people taking their kids to university this weekend.
Of course,
I mean,
massive.
Maddie's, Paddy is going to university.
Yeah, exactly. What are they going to do about petrol?
You know, there's a guy trapped in a traffic jam because he he's running out of fuel. He's got to go and pick up his kid from gymnastics.
Oh, God damn.
Is he a panicker?
No, exactly.
Or is he worried about going to pick up his
kid? And I think that's really important to say. And, you know, I remember being a bit judgy about people panic buying toilet paper. But that was at a time when we had lots of toilet paper. And I didn't understand why we were suddenly going to shit a lot more. But with petrol, I do think it's reasonable.
You're talking about people's livelihoods.
Yeah, livelihoods.
You know, you're listening to people say, I've got to get to my elderly mother. Yeah. I take her food every day. Why is that a panic? Why are we calling that panic?
Because the government want to shift the buck.
They want to say
it's not their fault.
It's everybody else's fault. It's the way people are responding to the fact that we couldn't get petrol to the petrol.
It's the fact that people are having any negative response to Brexit means they're going to blame it on the people having a negative response. This is the simplest psychology, and I worry as a country and as a nation, why do we keep voting them back in to do this? Where is Keir? Hang on, where is Keir?
He's, well, Angela Rayner is doing his speech. She's opening up the Labour conference today. And then they're all going to have a chat about how they're going to just look after themselves. That's the main focus.
That's the sound of Keir around the corner, babe.
I love that blue and jib.
Jib. So nice. What are you getting? A jib ship?
It's real creation, isn't it? Blimey, it's a lovely little street. Are you sure this street has never been...
Well, it has, but it's never had all those restaurants. Huh? Now look at this guy. No, I don't. Look. This is the first guy. We're out for the first time going to a proper restaurant, theatre, to see a proper play. And apparently you can sit next to each other with no masks on. So if we're going to get anything, we're going to get it tonight.
Lisa said she, because Lisa went to see Jamie last night, and she said she was freaking out. It was packed.
Was it?
Every single seat was taken.
Was it?
No masks.
Oh.
She said it was so scary. But yeah, this is the first time. You will know this, Sobs. Look, everywhere is so pretty. Look. Look at this.
It's Tiffany's.
You will know this. Oh, Tiffany's, I love Tiffany's. This is the first date we've been on in 10 years where it's not pouring with rain.
Oh my God, so it isn't.
Oh my God.
What?
Take the clothes from the display. Come on.
Look, they have, look.
Can you believe the tube?
It's just been
it?
Sabotaged by Cartier. Look.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Oh. In the middle of Sloane Square. Mind you, I suppose they're going to get away.
So tacky. Maybe it's a flower festival we knew nothing about.
So explain what...
I can't believe those people ravaging Cartier.
Explain what area we're in.
We're in Sloane Square, my darling.
Which is where the word Sloane's comes from.
Yeah, Sloane Mangers.
Yeah.
But it's one of our favourite little theatres here.
It's funny that it's such a little kind of... Left field theatre is in the middle of such poshness, isn't it?
And this place always reminds me, though it says the Rag and Bone New York, it was LA that we used to go into Rag and Bone.
Ah, yeah.
Ruby shop.
What is this?
What's going on?
What is this? Oh look, they've been made out of flowers.
Doesn't there some sort of event happening with flowers?
No, but are you getting that sculpture is made out of flowers?
Yeah.
I don't like it. Do you like it? I don't know if I like it.
It's a weird feeling around.
There's an enormous number of people walking around with plants and flowers. Look, there's one.
Of course it's made of been attacked by that pile of
No, but why are there people walking around with flowers and plants everywhere?
I don't know. It's maybe really... we never will. Oh, look, it's another pizza on the square off.
Oh, yeah, let's do it. Like proper tourists.
Like
I do too.
It's very, it's so lovely. I mean, God, this is.
It's mild and lovely.
It's so mild. Honestly,
oh, yeah. Look, I'm
Look, this is where I caught outside.
I have caught in the square. That's this is it. Look, have you seen my top?
That's good. Boxing.